What do you see on the screen? No, this is not a black spot, but an empty area in the sky at night. But can you really believe your eyes? After all, now you're peering not just at blackness, but at tens of thousands of luminous objects. However, until recently, this picture could only be seen with the help of telescopes. Meanwhile, we don't know who, when, or even if anyone has ever approached our solar system. And this is despite the fact that the scientific world recently announced that there are 20 exoplanets from which it's possible to contemplate our vast Earth and, most interestingly, even receive our radio transmissions. Do you already have thoughts that aliens are watching you? Throw away all negative thoughts and worries, because now you'll find out, what did the NASA space probe Juno manage to capture? What do we know about the largest planet in the solar system? And how would life develop on Earth without Jupiter? The gas giant Jupiter plays the role of a global vacuum cleaner by not allowing most asteroids and comets to reach us. Otherwise, constant catastrophes would hardly have allowed human civilization to reach its current level. That's why the study of our gigantic neighbor is a priority astronomical task. Launched on August 5, 2011, the Juno Robotic Interplanetary Spacecraft has become one of the most unique among such probes functioning in remote parts of the solar system. So, what's so special about it? The probe receives energy for operation from autonomous solar panels of various lengths, since Juno doesn't have a radioisotope thermoelectric generator. At the same time, the orbital station has been surviving the difficult conditions of space for many years and regularly provides scientists with valuable scientific information, especially about the gas giant Jupiter. So, how difficult was the journey to this distant and hostile world? Juno reached the huge planet 5 years after the launch of the mission and quickly found itself in its elliptical orbit. The probe's 5 scientific instruments were immediately activated. Further, it was assumed that the probe would continue to work in a tight orbit of the planet, but due to technical and software malfunctions, this plan failed. 2 years ago, the probe faced a difficult and dangerous situation. Due to a 53-day stay in an oblong orbit, Juno was forced to be in the dense, impenetrable shadow of the gas giant for about 12 hours. In this frightening location, borderline low temperatures and extremely low levels of light were recorded. So, it's not surprising that the planned capabilities of Juno didn't involve operating under such extreme conditions without the sun's rays. If the craft had stayed in the shadow of Jupiter just a little longer, it would probably have failed completely. So, as you can see, even the shadow of a gas colossus can pose a considerable danger to our space probes. Previously, the probe experienced a similar situation for a period of only 10 minutes. This happened literally just at the start of its mission, when Juno left the Earth and briefly fell into its shadow. But couldn't the ship have been reprogrammed to avoid contact with the giant shadow? One of the reasons why Juno didn't move to a lower orbit, but remained in an oblong elliptical one, was the strong gravitational field of Jupiter. The oblong trajectory of the ship's movement eliminates the influence of this force, and also ensures that the probe won't be in the shadow of the planet for too long. But it's not just difficulties that have accompanied the mission, there have been great successes as well. In April last year, Juno passed close to the surface of the gas giant's cloud layer, reaching an incredible speed of 206,000 kilometers per hour. So why focus on this? It's simple. Thanks to the lightning-fast maneuver, the probe sent dozens of amazing images and invaluable scientific data to Earth. in this despite the fact that the craft isn't able to stay so dangerously close to Jupiter for much time at all. This is due to the monstrous radiation emanating from the planet that can lead to multiple serious malfunctions, although the most important mechanisms of the ship are protected by special titanium plates. If this threat were ignored, then Juno's activities would have had to have been stopped ahead of schedule. How did it happen that after 12 hours spent in the shadow captivity of Jupiter, the orbital station was able to continue its mission? Desperate scientists went all in. They decided to spend a shocking amount of the craft's hydrazine jet fuel with a total weight of 73 kilograms to provide enough energy to keep Juno alive. As a result, the engine worked continuously for more than 10 hours. Why was the mission plan significantly adjusted? Juno was supposed to be near Jupiter for exactly 1 year, but in 2018 it was decided to extend its work until July 2021 because the project had showed exemplary results so far. And besides, funding for the mission had been increased significantly. In general, during operation, Juno made 35 extremely close loops just above the surface of Jupiter. What else did the probe please scientists with? Astronomers have received a huge amount of valuable data about Jupiter. Using a microwave radiometer capable of penetrating more than 500 kilometers into clouds, the probe transmitted information to Earth about the deepest parts of the gas giant's atmosphere. From this, the researchers were able to find out how much water and ammonia are contained in the atmospheric layers in percentage terms. Another goal of the Juno mission was to collect information about how Jupiter was formed and at what depths atmospheric flows circulate, in order to obtain more extensive data on the phenomena occurring in the magnetosphere and to map the force regions near the gas giant. The probe activated a special device that determines the position of objects relative to magnetic fields. As for the ultraviolet radiation spectrograph, with its help, scientists received more detailed information about Jupiter's auroras, dazzlingly sparkling at the poles of the planet. And in order to make a map that can be used to calculate mass distribution on Jupiter, a special device estimated the magnitude of the fields of the gas giant. But how did such impressive photographs of our gigantic neighbor appear? The only static camera on Juno is to be commended for that. It was this tricolor, highly intelligent gadget that contributed to the amazing images of Jupiter that flew around the world. Titanic cyclones and anticyclones recorded in the area of the Great Red Spot and at the poles also made their way into the lens of this wonderful camera. Which valuable and significant discoveries can we single out over the entire period of Juno's mission? In particular, it was confirmed that Jupiter has a high-density core, but it contains loose and porous material and not solidified hydrogen or stones as previously assumed. The formation process of this structural element is still unknown. Most likely, a clarification of this riddle will be a goal of Jupiter's further research. In any case, at the moment, we've received much more information about many phenomena. For example, we've learned more about what's happening inside the famous anticyclone hurricane called the Great Red Spot. The strange whirlwind has been observed since the 19th century, and since then its size has decreased significantly. Right now, the diameter of the storm is 1.3 tenths the diameter of the Earth. Back in 1979, it was closer to double the diameter of our planet. Juno also found that the crater at the base of the Great Red Spot, the so-called Eye of the Hurricane, has an incredible depth of around 300 kilometers, and local temperatures rise significantly as you approach the center. This explains the appearance of powerful winds in the upper layers of the hurricane. Juno also received information about the anomalies occurring in the magnetic field of Jupiter. In particular, its asymmetry, which is observed in the complex structure of the field in the Northern Hemisphere. Scientists can't say anything definite about the reasons for this phenomenon, since the magnetic fields of Jupiter and the Earth are significantly different. There have been suggestions that these are the consequences of the dissolution of Jupiter's core. Researchers were very surprised to find a very bright, narrow band emitting ultraviolet. This discovery was facilitated by the ultraviolet spectrograph installed on Juno. Is this a miraculous transformation of Jupiter into a star? Most probably not. Perhaps this was just lightning strikes, very powerful ones. The peculiarity of the ultraviolet band signal is that just after detection, it immediately disappeared. There's a theory that we observed a phenomenon called sprites, lightning discharges that are extremely rare. If such flashes of light were found on Earth, we would notice their reddish hue, and on Jupiter, due to the large amount of hydrogen, the bands appear blue. Another important discovery made by Juno was the detection of an abundant amount of water molecules at the equator, as well as signs that the planet once had heavy rains. And a long time ago, Jupiter experienced a bombardment of ammonia hail and powerful lightning strikes. These elements were the most important factor in the formation of the cycle of water layers on Jupiter. Also, with the help of Juno, it was possible to determine the most arid region of the planet, a kind of Jovian desert located in the Northern Hemisphere slightly above the equator. And what about the cloud layer on Jupiter? Astronomers carefully analyzed the cloud images provided by the probe and found the following. They clearly show that the atmospheric masses that are above the polar cyclones move counterclockwise, while the hurricane spirals rotate clockwise. As we've already said, the main part of the Juno mission was completed in July 2021, but this doesn't mean that the device was sent to a well-deserved rest. The current state of the probe will allow it to continue working until at least 2025. During this period, Juno will make four more orbits around Jupiter, gradually approaching the North Pole of the gas giant, which will contribute to obtaining more data on the three-dimensional structure of polar hurricanes. Also, Juno will approach three of Jupiter's moons, namely Europa, Ganymede, and Io. Project leaders hope that they'll be able to obtain a lot of valuable information about these distant objects. This will greatly facilitate the work of subsequent missions organized to study the surface of the Galilean moons. In particular, scientists intend to find out the thickness of the ice layer of Europa and capture the geysers on its surface, as well as get ahead of whether there's a global ocean of molten magma in the depths of Io. The above tasks only seem impossible. In fact, provided that all the devices on Juno work correctly, information can and will be obtained. And then scientists will finally be able to create maps of the satellite's surfaces and compare them with data received from the Galileo probe. It was a visitor to Jupiter long before the arrival of Juno. Another object for research by the probe will be the so-called gas and dust rings encircling Jupiter. The device will have to find out how matter is distributed in them, as well as unravel the secret of the wave nature of these unknown structures. If in the future we receive more news from Juno, we'll definitely tell you about it. We're absolutely sure that many more incredible discoveries are awaiting humanity ahead. Right now, we are rapidly rushing into the future, and who knows, maybe in 10 years, the surface of the planets and their satellites will become as commonplace as reality shows on Earth. Oh, if only the number of Hubble's likes and subscribers could bring this long-awaited moment closer. But we are able to influence something else, the earliest possible release of a new educational video. Share videos with your friends, and don't skimp on moral encouragement. The universe will reward you. And if 15,000 likes are collected under this video, then the speed of the release of the new video will surpass the speed of light. Don't believe me? Check it out.